Hello YouTube, Hot Lead Retired here. I don't have a lot of time on this video. I gotta cover 5 points. I want Donald Trump to win the presidency. I'm a big Donald Trump supporter. But anyway, here's some tips for Donald Trump. They're attacking him on some issues, and one issue is, alright, his foreign policy, his bankruptcy filing when he was doing business deals. The way he comes back and insults people, just being brutally honest, I guess, and something new about the guy that asked a question where he was taking a town hall meeting where he was having questions and answer session. The guy mentioned that everybody knows Obama is a Muslim, and it was about the radical Muslim training camps in the United States, terrorist training camps. All right, and other issues. Also, he's been attacked where he's donated money to Democrats and Republicans and flipped back and forth between liberal, Republican, and Democratic parties. There's one more issue. Oh, the immigration policy. That's really not an issue. But anyway, I'm going to cover these. As far as that, the town hall meeting where Trump was asked a question by an audience member, and the audience member stated that Obama was a Muslim. And Trump's taking heat because he didn't correct the guy. Donald Trump needs to respond to, hey, I believe in the United States Constitution and a right of freedom of free speech, the First Amendment, and he should say something like, well, I'm an opinionated person myself, and I don't sugarcoat stuff. So why should I stand in the way of blocking this guy's freedom of expression? If I believe in the Constitution and I express my opinions myself. He just needs to word that to where they're wanting to censor someone's opinion. The government is wanting to censor someone's opinion. And it's illegal to do that. It's illegal to censor someone's First Amendment right. So Trump is just obeying the Constitution. And anybody that criticizes him for not correcting the guy is just another part of the problem of expressing free speech. So there you go. And when a career politician is up on stage in a debate and they question Donald Trump's foreign policy abilities, Mr. Trump should just say something along the lines of this: I am not a politician. I've never held public office. The politicians in Congress and the Senate and in the White House created that mess over in the Middle East. They created it, not me. I'm going there to straighten it out. And if that politician that brings it up says I didn't support Obama on those issues, then all Trump has to fire back is, well, you didn't do anything to stop it. You let it happen. And when I'm in the White House, I will stop it. Or I will straighten it out. I'll straighten out the mess. That's all he has to say. He needs to put everything back onto the politician, because Trump wasn't in office to create the mess to start with. He's an outsider. He's not a politician. So he has no responsibilities at all for that. It's the people up on stage that's been in office for 10, 20, their whole life in politics that caused the mess. They caused it. Trump's going to straighten it out. That's what he needs to respond with. And he could do that on about 90% of his questions ever asked, you know. And when they start blasting Trump about the way he insults people and attacks people's character, or whatever, Trump needs to respond with something like this. The people are tired of the lies from Washington, the backdoor deals, undercover crap that goes on. It's supposed to be like transparency, but it's not happening. The people are tired of it. I'm not here for you guys. I'm talking about the candidates and the politicians. I'm not here for you guys. I'm here for the American people, and they want to hear the truth, no matter how brutal it is. We're tired of being lied to. We're tired of politicians standing on the fence on an issue, and they're not going to vote one way or another, and they won't stand up for what they believe in, and they won't fight for what they believe in. That's why this country is in the mess it is now. That's all Donald Trump has to do. He has to put everything back on the candidates that's been in office for 10, 20, 30 years. They're the ones that caused this mess, not Donald Trump. They're the ones. All right, when they attack Trump, I don't know if I covered this, but I got a little bit more on it. But if they attack Trump on his foreign policy, Trump needs to respond with something like this. When I am president, I will have around me the great military minds, foreign policy experts as advisors. And unlike President Obama and the current administration, I will take advice from these experts. And as far as a career politician asking him anything about the current his foreign policy abilities, he should fire back with, "You've been in office all your life, and the country is a mess. The Middle East is a mess. And the policies that you created or failed to stop is the reason why the Middle East is in such a mess. That's why our whole foreign policy is such a mess. And I'm going to be the one, when I get up there, to straighten it out with my advisors." That's all he needs to say. Put it back on their asses, man. They're the ones that created that mess, not you. You're an American citizen. You're not a politician. They're the ones that created that mess. Trump needs to be the one that says, "I'm going to go up there and straighten that mess out," and put it back on the politician, man. As far as the immigration policy goes, Donald Trump is spot on. He's spot on. We need the wall. We need to deport the illegal immigrants. Even if they have kids born in America, Trump needs to say something like, "We're going to deport the parents. We're going to, if they want to, if we'll give them the option to take their kids with them back to wherever they came from. Or they can leave them here in the country. We'll raise them till they're 18 and then they're on their own." But if we also need an incentive to get, I know there's 11 million people out there. It's going to be hard. They say it's impossible to deport them, which it probably pretty much is. We need incentives for them to turn themselves in and be deported. And some of them incentives could be, all right, if you don't turn yourself in within 1 year or 6 months or whatever it is, and we catch you, you can never enter this country again legally. And I'm talking on vacation with a passport, a green card, anything. You cannot come into this country to work, to visit, to go to school, whatever. Nothing. Zilch. You're forever eliminated. All right? If you decide to turn yourself in and be self-deported, you will retain the option in the future to come into the United States on a passport, green card, as even as a U.S. citizen, you know, legally. All right, there's your options. Now, if the parents decide to be, if we deport the parents back to Mexico, they decide to leave their child in America, then they lose the same thing. They lose all future options to ever become a U.S. citizen, to enter this country on a green card, passport, visa, whatever. To go to school, nothing. They cannot come in this country at all. But if they decide to take their child with them to the country they came from, they can enter the United States legally with a passport, a green card, or become a U.S. citizen. Legally. There you go. And anyone we catch after that 6 or month or a year waiting period, they lose it all and they get deported. And if it takes 100 years, it takes 100 years. But you got to get the wall built first to keep them from coming back in. That's what Trump needs to say. He needs to come up with incentives to get people to leave and secure the wall and, you know, answer back with that. That's a tough but fair immigration policy. And all it's doing is going by the laws that we already have. That's the law right now. We're just not enforcing it. Oh, and another thing. The Border Patrol, immigration, and law enforcement need to work hand in hand in order for this to work. When they pick up an illegal immigrant, they need to call immigration, and they got to deport him back to Mexico or wherever he came from. There's no amnesty cities. Get rid of all that. And they need to start doing their job. And the government needs to let them do their job. That's what Trump needs to say. All right, thanks for watching.